cầu lên coi.
Hello everyone, welcome to my vlog. My name is Khánh Duy, I'm from class DAN1201 and I'm here to take you guys on my field trip at my school. I hope you enjoy the vlog as well as my YouTube videos. Let's hit the subscribe button and hit that like button. Thank you very much. First, we visit the Jasir Melanuga Forest. This place is particularly special because it is covered with a river running alongside with the forest. As you can see here, we have a kind of like a driver but on a boat. You can say a sailor that took us on the riverside and takes pictures, and while we were boating, they will introduce to us some of the local and some of the beauty that cannot be seen anywhere else but this place. Yeah, as you can see, these are some spectacular flowers that are only kind of like existed in Vietnam and Asia. Like, this is called Hoa Sen, which is kind of like floating flower, especially on a swamp, and you only get to see it when you ride along the boat. Yes, and these are the forests, and so along the journey I took some photo and make some memory here. This is our first stop on our journey to the west, and yeah. First night at the city and the first night market ever. We rocked the hell out of the place and yeah, just did some pretty cool things. The next stop on our journey, we visit the Sombrom Pagoda. This place is particularly beautiful and is an outstanding out of all the visit places we've done because of the statue of the Buddhist. This statue is the largest one ever in this land, and it is measured to be about more than 100 feet, you know, the size of a football field, the length of it. And as you can see here, the Buddha is lying down, and in this form, he's laying eyes on those who visit to gaze upon us all. And inside the pagoda, the temple, is some of the remarkable artwork shift from the ancient one. It remains a mystic and knowledgeable drawings. These tells different story as well as the backstory from where it began. I like us better when we're wasted. So after a long journey during the day, we got to relax and we decided to join our friends on a journey to the night market hangout. We spent a lot of time there, as you can see. We did a lot of things, such as riding the electronic motorcycle, which was a lot of fun. We have never tried that before, and I'm glad that we tried. We did some ice cream and we did some, you know, just the local game, the local food. Not so much different from where we staying, but the different review from the market gave you know, some of the fun stuff. Yeah, we had a crazy night at the night market. So in the next morning, we get ourselves to the awesome journey to the Back Liu house. This guy is famous for being filthy rich. His family is rich because of selling salt, which didn't have much seller back then, but that's why he's very filthy rich. He's famous for spending a lot on things, and the most famous thing is he's spending on a girl to win her heart. And yeah, we get to visit the place of his. This is the house of Back Liu, and some of the things there are very valuable, such as the wooden bed, wooden chair, and the gigantic house. It estimates to be more than billions in the economy nowadays, so you can say he's a very rich man from the age that he lived. So on the next day, we visit the floating market. We decided to change our destination because we want something more different. So basically, throughout the day, we have been on land, so this time we're gonna be on water. This is basically not so much different from the market on the land, except that the sailor often go by boats, you know. They access our boat and they try to sell some, and we deal with our trade right on the seawater. And yeah, not so much different. After you arrive for a long journey, we kind of like stop at the stations, and this is kind of like big. They have all the local that you cannot find anywhere else, like fish, dried fish, candies. So on our next journey, we get to visit Hùng Temple. Now Hùng is shortcut for Hùng Vương. He's the ancient king of a country. He is said to have fought many fearsome enemies and has pushed down the invasion with the magical bow that a turtle gave to him. It can shoot like thousands of arrows at once, and it lived on to the day of today. And many stories and many philosophy has based on it, and were told by parents, adults to children nowadays. And this temple is the memorial of the kings. We built it in honor to honor the kings that saved us from their enemies and all the invasion and stuff. This place is very huge. It's kind of like a 2 football field, and it is covered with trees, greens, and stones that carve with quotes, lesson that from the former adults, passing on to the generations. And inside is the things that existed thousands of years ago that cannot be found anywhere else. It consists of weapons, arts, and tools. As you can see here, we can see archery bows, knife, and swords, and especially we can see the gong, which is kind of like a drum, but this one kind of stand out because it is carved on the metal, and each of the gong, it represents a different kind of stories. It's kind of like the history that cannot be erased from the paper, and it can be passed down from generation to generations. Yeah, you can see now. And from time to time, when you get... And this is the end of a journey, and we got to relax, and we decided to spend the rest of the hanging out. And these are some of the photos that I took. Give a lot of memories that I would never, for God's sake, will forget in age.
Well, the lights don't move and the colors don't fade. Leaves you empty with nothing but dreams. In a world gone shallow, in a world gone mean.